Well, the history begins in the Red Library. Of Gustavo's house. His brothers had gone with Christopher Robin arrived at Gustavo's house. He asked about his brother and he asked about Christopher Robin's friends. He told Gustavo, I am Jules. My brothers and my parents went to a fecing match with Uncle Jil and they stay until night. Christopher, why do you say you are alone? Yes, your grandfather was the one who opened the door for me. Well, anyway, Christopher, today we will go to the bamboo forest. I have to go see Enrique Koala, who is a little sick to his stomach. He didn't want to eat. Christopher Robin, do you have medicine for him to take it? Yes, I bring your medicine. I got dressed and were leaving. It's urgent that you take your medicine. He got dressed and they left accidentally, but on an outfit jobs like Christopher Robin's, and didn't realize it until later on the way to the bamboo forest. Gustavo, for leaving my house quickly, I didn't notice the clothes I wore. They are the same as yours, Christopher. Christopher, don't worry, and I'll tell you one thing. You look good dressed. The same indicates that you are my friends. Finally arrived at the bamboo forest where they found Enrique Koala lying down, and he said, Enrique Koala. Hello, Gustavo. I see that you have brought a new friend. I would like to be with you, but I fall sick to my stomach. He stopped up and told her. Gustavo, Enrique, I bring you your medicine. You will feel like a better friend. He gave him the medicine and they stayed for a long time on the big coal. And Rick Koala got over his stomach to buy him. Enrique Koala. I feel better. Thanks, Gustavo. What is the name of our new friend? His name is Christopher Robin. Lives in the 100 acre wood with our friends. Only they aren't with him right now, Enrique. You will meet them at some point. After Enrique Koala recovered from his stomach, they will return home, Christopher Robin, to his house in the 100 acre wood, and he to his house where his parents, along with his brother and Uncle Jil, were waiting for him for dinner. At dinner, they talk about the fecing competition, which Uncle Jil won. Uncle Jil showed them the trophy that he won in that fecing competition. He just said, "So that was cool, Uncle Jil." Was great. Dinner continued, and he told them what he had done in all that time. His parents, brothers, and Uncle Jim had been away. Good morning, Uncle Jil. Good morning, Missy. morning, Dad. Good morning, son. Oh, good morning. Good morning, grandfather. Good morning, grandson. Significa nephew, the breakfast is ready. Thanks, Uncle Jil. Thank you. I am going to do for the fish. Flashback is seen where he is fading in the fish. There is a lot of fog.